Okay, coach, it is always a celebration here in New Orleans, and we are just outside of the French Quarter at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Indianapolis Colts. This is Alvin Kamara, who made the Pro Bowl in each of his first two NFL seasons. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
What's the old expression, 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now, ready. We've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
Here we go. On second down, Kamara. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 10 yards, good for his Saints, first down. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there, and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
No gain on the play. It'll be second down. Defense doing their job, really nowhere to run the football.
Yeah, it's almost textbook, wasn't it? Every place he tried to find an open spot, there just wasn't one. Congrats to the defense, no gain.
Call fitting your gaps, right?
I love it. You're exactly right.
Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down.
Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. From the gun, it's Breeze. And that is incomplete.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him.
And here's Morstead now as he sends this one away. It's a 45-yard punt, 6 yards on the return. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. Out once more comes the Indianapolis Colts offense, and we've talked about the quarterback spot, Jacoby Brissett back there, but now they've got Marlon Mack, who fractured his hand out indefinitely after having surgery. They think he'll return this season, but look, the rushing game was really good in week 11, 264 yards. That was their best team rushing performance in 15 years. If they can get Mack back, this team is starting to round into form.
It certainly is, and the good thing for them is they had two 100-yard rushers in this last game. Marlon Mack, as you mentioned before, but how about Jonathan Williams stepping up for them? So now with Mack out, it'll be Jonathan Williams' ball to carry. And we'll see if he'll continue to gallop for the Colts.
So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. This is Hines. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Tackle there going to Marshawn Lattimore.
All right, Brandon, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. They go play action with Brissett. And he fires one that's intercepted. It's A.J. Klein, the linebacker. And he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. So a good starting field position for him here as they come up 1st and 10 at their own 43. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to 2nd and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. Breeze leaves this one with Kamara, and he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down.
I like the strategy. Extra tight ends, extra beef. They want to run the football, but that means they probably want to run it inside. If you get strung out on the perimeter, you're in peril.
Yeah, we saw the result, negative yardage. Now they'll throw with Breeze. He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. Speaking of Michael Thomas, 94 catches on the year through week 11. He's the first receiver ever, Charles, to top the 90 reception mark in his team's first 10 games.
And what makes it even more remarkable is not that he's just an exceptional talent who's worked his way into being one of the top receivers in the league. He's done it with two different quarterbacks this year. When Drew Brees got hurt and went out, he connected with Teddy Bridgewater, similar fashion, and put up big numbers. The all-time record, it's 143 held by Marvin Harrison, and I will guarantee you this, Michael Thomas knows that number.
Ready.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Back to the ground, it's Kamara. And that play went nowhere. Losing yardage, it'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Early down stuff's to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
On second and 11 now, Breeze. And now look at him go. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD.
Now that was a beautiful play. A pick six. How would you punctuate something like that, partner?
What, you mean with an exclamation mark?
Exclamation mark, a big word. What would you do with that?
Ampersand?
I like it.
Now Adam Vinatieri for the point after. And this is good to make it 7-0 Indy. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. CD, I want to ask you about the NFC South as the Saints come back out onto the field here.
Okay.
You know, they're 8-2, and that win against Tampa 34-17 in week 11 just furthered their advantage in the division. They've now got a three-game lead over Carolina. Is this one all but over?
I think so. But going into the season, didn't we think this would be one of the most competitive divisions in the league? Because I thought Atlanta would press New Orleans first. Carolina, you know, is always good. Tampa was an unknown. But how about this? Three of the next four at home for this New Orleans Saints team. Carolina comes to town, and then they get a revenge game. Because remember, Atlanta jumped them a couple weeks ago in New Orleans. That's on Thanksgiving night in Atlanta. And then at home for a monster game against San Francisco. And another one against Indianapolis.
From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And this has been a recurring theme tonight for sure. Nowhere to run. Back to the line of scrimmage, that's all. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now Breeze on third down. And this is going to be incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. So a change of possession here on the punt. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. They've got a 7-0 lead in the football as well as they start out first and 10. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. This is Marlon Mack, third year running back. And he'll get two, maybe three, up near the 37.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
On second down, here's a run with Mack. And he's got some space here. The Red Sea parts, and there he goes. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. A huge play that time for the Colts. 61 yards that time on the ground. After the big play, a chance to finish now on first and goal. And he takes it in for a Colts score.
Touchdown.
A 1 yard touchdown reception. And the Colts, they add on to their advantage. Early on, they have all facets of the game working in tandem.
Yeah, you get the defensive touchdown early to give you the first score. And then your offense piggybacks on top of that and gets their own. And any coach we've ever talked to, and we've had that conversation with them prior to the game, they always say, you know, if we can score on defense or special teams, that gives like a 95% chance of winning the game. I don't know if that number's correct, but it certainly does tend to play out that way, doesn't it?
It does. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game. And typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13. Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
Yeah, baby.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
55, 56. Let's go, D. It's going to be a long day offense. It's going to be tight.
Throwing on 2nd and 8. Breeze, and his throw is incomplete. Traquan Smith, the intended receiver, and it's 3rd down.
Let's face it, if you want to get back into the game, these are the kind of throws you got to hit. He's wide open right there. Got to be able to get it to him, don't you think?
And those are the throws that haven't been available to them every time he's dropped a pass. Yeah, that's a big miss. So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Now the throw on 3rd down, knocked away and incomplete. Darius Leonard, the linebacker, able to break that one up.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on 3rd down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a 4th down decision.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he's on to punt for New Orleans. And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. And a nice job here on special teams. This will be down inside the 10 at the 8-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. First down, Brissett. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. And they'll mark him down right around the 9, just shy of the 10. Just a 1-yard pickup on the play, and that'll bring up 2nd down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Now, meanwhile, here's a 2nd down throw that's knocked away and incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Now Brissett. And Pascal's got it. And he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done. A good pickup there, 21 yards. So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Play fake, Brissett. That's complete to Marlon Mack. Now the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on 2nd down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Here's Hines. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a 1/2 yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. And for the Saints here on 3rd down, an extra defensive back on the field. They run the counter. Hines, and it's a fumble.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. 2 first downs have him up to the 41 now for 1st and 10. Now it's Hines. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Give the Colts 13 yards and a 1st down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
So in Saints territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 47. They'll run on 1st down with Marlon Mack. Tackle made there by Kiko Alonso.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Let's put him on the buses. Let's put that team on the bus.
draw play. This is Hines. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
But we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
An eight-play drive to this point. So here's play number nine on third and seven. From the shotgun, it's Bissett. Taken in by the tight end, Doyle. 2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands.
To punt on fourth down, here's Rigoberto Sanchez. Deontay Harris deep for New Orleans. And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked out inside the 5-yard line.
Absolutely love the flexibility of these punters. Their leg drive, able to get it way up in the air, and that allows their punt team to get down there and down it inside the 10 because they've had some time.
Ready. 95-56.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And a short gain here as he gets it up only to about the 6. Anthony Walker, the other Colts linebacker with over 100 tackles a year ago, making the play there.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage.
On the ground, this is Kamara. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
And he finds Cook. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. It'll be a Saints first down on a gain of 16 yards.
Jared Cook is a guy who's been around the NFL. He's been with the Titans, the Rams, the Packers, and the last 2 years in Oakland. Now he makes a move to the Big Easy, where he pairs with Drew Brees and forms a nice little threat.
Kamara. And that time, the tackle by Malik Hooker.
When we see those runs to the perimeter, when we see those runs to the edge, we think about big breakers, don't we? In this case, it was a modest gain, but it does open up possibilities here on second down.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They run from the shotgun with Washington. And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a 3rd and inches situation.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, 2 for 5 to this point. They're looking at 3rd in the nose of the football. Off the play fake to Kamara, it's Breeze. And Ginn's got it. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. It'll be a Saints first down on a pickup of 13.
His 13th NFL season now. Ted Ginn, still a reliable target for Drew Brees. 787 yards in 2017, just 5 games last year due to injuries, but he still has the wheels.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. On the counter, here's Kamara. A gain of 3, 2nd down.
Not much happening there on 1st down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Three yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. Breeze now. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a 3rd down.
Barnard, I think it's high time to get him some passes that he's comfortable with, some easy throws, some completions. He's not even hitting to 50% thus far.
Well, certainly that has played a big role into why they are trailing right now. Well, this drive, they're 2 for 2 on third down conversions, but they need 7 yards here. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. So a couple of first downs on this drive, but it's looking like another empty possession.
And those empty possessions are certainly starting to pile up. So the adjustments that teams talk about all the time have to be taking place. They've got to analyze what's breaking down and figure a way to fix it.
And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. And a good result there as that'll get out of bounds and pin him back at their 10-yard line. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? But it definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
Push him back.
We're set on first down. The sack coming from defensive end Cameron Jordan.
Now, this is where field awareness comes into play. He's getting perilously close to his own goal line, and after that sack, backed up to his own 2.
And the job becomes twice as difficult now after the sack. It's 2nd and 20. Here's Mack. And he'll get this up past the 5 to the 7-yard line. He was able to pick up 6 yards there, so that leaves him with a 3rd and 13.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. He'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
The Colts on 3rd down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13. Brissett now. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And the tackle made at the 13. He is well short of the first. The completion good for only 6, and that'll bring up 4th.
One of the money routes for any offense, the drag route. So tough to defend because the receiver can stop at any point and make himself available to the quarterback and get a completion. But I love the communication we saw there. All the defenders pointing out the receiver, where he was going, and then they're able to rally to the ball after the catch and stop him short of a first down.
Yeah, a 7-yard return following a punt of 45 yards. And the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here. And they're in a bind early here, down 14-0. Are you worried at this stage or still too early?
You're worried. You're just trying not to transmit it to the rest of your team. You want to make sure that they stay positive. But at the same time, you're wondering, how are we going to move the football? What do we have on this play sheet that can work? Get back to basics is usually your answer, and make sure you find the guy who can move the ball fastest for you if you just get it in his hands.
Yeah, still 2nd quarter. You get points on the board here. I think you're feeling okay. After the loss to start out, here's 2nd and 11.
All day, just like that, just like that.
Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And brought in by the tight end, Cook. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on 2nd down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now it gives them a much better opportunity to convert on 3rd down.
The Saints on 3rd down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This will be 3rd and 5. Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect. Some of the fans here don't seem too happy about what we've seen in this first half.
No, not at all, and I understand why. They've looked lethargic, out of sync, and it shows on the scoreboard.
Here's Thomas Morstead now, as he'll come on for his 5th kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. 33 yards is the distance on the punt there, and the Colts are going to take over, albeit deep in their own territory. So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong, you know, back and forth like that? But it definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
On 1st and 10, Brissett.
And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. The linebacker, DeMario Davis, got a hand in to break that one up.
And with that, folks, want to remind you to join the NFL Salute to Service. This season, the NFL and its players are honoring those who proudly serve our country, and fans are encouraged to join NFL players in writing letters to service members and their families. To learn how you can send your letter today, visit NFL.com/salute.
A second down throw for Brissett, and incomplete.
Didn't have a receiver open downfield, and as it turned out, couldn't even find his outlet man because of the coverage. It was way too tight, unable to find anyone open.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. From the gun, here's Brissett. Complete to Hilton. And he's brought down, but not before they get it across the 20-yard line. Give the Colts 13 yards and a first down.
Did you see that route the way that I did? I thought he was trying to get deep.
Yeah, that wasn't the first option.
No, not at all. It came off of that guy, the deep guy, and came underneath on the drag, completed it very well.
They'll run on first down. It's Hines. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. That's good for an Indianapolis first down on a gain of 10.
Yeah, they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last two possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Out of bounds just shy of the 45. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Looking to throw again on second down. Brissett, T.Y. Hilton, the intended receiver. And that takes us from second to third down. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined, but sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, you don't have defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to rip it.
And the Saints' pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he's on to punt for Indianapolis. 44 on his first punt, and this is a good kick as well. Harris now to return. 12 yards on the return that time, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Out onto the field comes New Orleans.
These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The sack by Marcus Hunt.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I think they're just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
Been such an impressive first half to get that lead.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. Now Breeze finding Kamara. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime.
These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. From the gun, it's Breeze. It's caught, Smith. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 14 yards is the pickup, first down, New Orleans.
The Saints spent a third-round pick on Tre'Quan Smith out of UCF in 2018, and what a thrilling season for him. He was the guy that caught the pass from Drew Brees that moved him past Peyton Manning to become the all-time leading passer in NFL history.
Out of the backfield, that's complete to Kamara. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Four yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. Now, Breeze again. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 7 yards there and a first down. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
We got this.
So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So a big play before the end of the half to get him into this spot, and they cash in with three.
How about the 1-2 to the solar plexus on that one? The big play, the field goal, not much time left on the clock. That's the way to go into the half.
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals, because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
So we are at halftime here on a Monday night, as we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone, and no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
56, Mike, 56, right there.
That's into the hands of Pascal. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. A gain of six there on first.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. And he got half of what he needed there, 2 yards, and it'll bring up a third and two more.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. A good throw here, finding Pascal. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. It's a loss of a full 3 yards, and it brings up fourth down. Well, they opted not to run it. They completed the pass on third and two, but they lost yardage to bring up four.
Well, give credit to the guys on the other side of the ball. They snuffed out the play, but it does bring into question, one, the play call, because they didn't run the ball there. They could have run it. And two, just not getting it. That's got to be deflating for them.
It's a 45-yard punt, just a one-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Now the attention turns to the Saints offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Well, partner, let's look league-wide for a second and think playoffs here. I'm going to give you some teams, and you tell me if they still have a chance at the AFC wild card or are they just waiting until next year. How about Cleveland at 4-6? And he'll be brought down by the Colts. Credit that sack to Jabal Sheard.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they've struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
On third and long, it's Breeze. And the pressure gets to him again. Margus Hunt able to drop him that time for his second sack of the evening.
I remember when I was a kid and all I wanted was a nickel so I could get that soda down at the fountain. And guess what? The nickel came into play well. Five defensive backs, they covered well, allowed for the sack.
Sodas were a nickel when you were a kid?
No, I just needed the extra nickel so I could pay the, so I could pay the proper price.
Okay, how much were they, a dime? What were they?
15 cents.
It'll be a 10-yard return following a punt of 45. And the Colts are set up well as they take over first and 10 on the short side of the field. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. This crew had to punt last time they had the ball, but when you've got a lead like this, you contend to play the field position game?
You are to an extent, especially if you like your defense, because you have the lead, you've been controlling the game. But why put them in a tougher spot? You want to get out there and get something done on offense and maybe take command of this game yourself.
David Onyemata there on the tackle.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. On second and 9. Brissett, and a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. On first down, Hines. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
Now a throw to the end zone on first down, but it winds up incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Brissett. He'll check this down to Hines. And he'll get it down this time to the 17. It's a gain of 7, and they're going to face a third down. A second down completion got him 7. Now here's third and 3.
To throw is Brissett. And Pascal's got it. And he's got the first down as he gets it to the 8. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Brissett. And a little floater there, but it'll wind up incomplete, falling to the ground.
You and I watched film yesterday, and you told me to watch his feet. Well, for whatever reason, his footwork just looked off on that throw.
And you always love it when an ex-defensive back talks quarterback mechanics, right?
Well, but you're good at it.
Well, I try, all right? I don't know how good I am, but it doesn't take much to tell. His mechanics are off a little bit, exactly what you described. Footwork, that led to the incompletion.
And he's going to pull his way down to about the 1 yard line.
Easy work.
Seven big yards on the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with third down upcoming.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard.
They'll try to run with Hines. Uh-oh, he is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. No gain on the play, and what to do now on fourth and goal.
Defense didn't budge on third down. Now what are we going to see on fourth?
We are soon to find out, but does this feel like old school football or what?
Oh,
right?
Yeah.
This is an old-fashioned goal line stand. I know what I would call on offense. I would go for it.
And this is caught for a touchdown. Now hold everything here. Flag in the backfield. This one might be coming back.
Good work, boys. Let's go.
So with fourth down coming up, here's Adam Vinatieri now for the Colts field goal. Vinatieri's kick is good. And they will stretch the lead now to 17-3.
Vinatieri, the NFL's oldest active player, also the league's all-time leading scorer, past Morton Anderson last year.
Yeah, he turned 46 in December of 2018. He really can't see it in his leg. Maybe in the beard.
You can see it in the beard.
Maybe in the beard, that's about it. But as long as he's booting them the way he's booting them, keep going, big guy.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. Back out onto the field now comes the New Orleans offense.
These guys had to punt last time. It has not been a very fruitful game offensively thus far. They haven't even made a trip to the red zone.
And I know that everyone's going crazy on that sideline, because that drives you berserk to come off the field, not really move the ball well. As you said, not even get to the red zone, let alone, you know, not even put points on the board. They've got to just take a deep breath, relax, try and figure out what is working, and call more of that.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time, because let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Shotgun now for Breeze. That's complete to his running back, Kamara. He'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Now Breeze. Incomplete. He had his hands on it but couldn't pick it. But it's now fourth down.
And we're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off.
Here's Thomas Morstead now as he's on to punt for New Orleans. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12.
One of the advantages of zone defense, as I remember it, is being able to see the play develop in front of you. One of the disadvantages, when they find those levels where they can hit you with it. Sometimes behind the corner and in front of the safety, it makes it tough to defend.
They'll run on first down. Mack, and he'll rumble for about 5, up close to the 40.
Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D. Put it.
To throw, Brissett. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Cameron Jordan in there to get him yet again. That is his 3rd sack tonight. They can't figure him out. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
On 3rd down, Brissett. Yeah, that one's going to be knocked away. And incomplete. Eli Apple, good to the core there as he gets in and knocks it away. Well, those two have hooked up for a touchdown once already in this game, that time unable to find the completion.
Yeah, it just appeared they wanted to get him out into open space and try and get him the football. As you mentioned, unable to connect.
Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez as he's on to punt. Oh, here's pressure and the Saints block it. It's picked up and this is a live ball, remember. And he'll score. Touchdown, New Orleans. In for the score as his guys are back within a single score.
Partners, you well know every block punt wasn't necessarily a called block. Sometimes the guy just finds his way back there. Doesn't matter. The play happens, and that one turned into 6 points because they handled it so well after the block.
Lutz good on the extra point, and that slices the lead down to 17-10. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. Start on the ground with Hines. And he's upended after a gain of 2 out to the 27.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Here's Brissett. That's complete to Hines out of the backfield. No gain there, and it's going to bring up a third down. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. From the shotgun, it's Brissett. He'll find Hines out of the backfield. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Good yardage there for the Colts. 18 and a first down. And at his size, he's a smaller back. You can get him to football. He can kind of get lost, make someone miss. It's good for him.
Yeah, it's great for him. I like what you said there. Sometimes he gets lost in the traffic a little bit. But get him out in the open field into some space. That plays to his strengths the best and keeps him out of it where all the big boys are. You know, make him make someone miss in the open field.
Marcus Davenport there to take him down.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Let's make these babies cry.
On second and nine, Brissett. He's got it to Hilton. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 42.
Slant route's effective no matter who's running the route and catching the ball. But when you have a receiver of that stature, you have to be a little bit more precise throwing it. You don't have the same catch radius with the bigger targets.
So in Saints territory now, here's first and 10 at the 42-yard line. They run with Hines. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
On second and 12, Brissett. And that would not to be. It's incomplete. So they couldn't hook up as time has now run out on this third quarter of play. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Colts. They've got control of the football. They also have the lead as we start the fourth. The Colts on third down. They've converted five times in their many chances thus far. This is third down and 12. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. And he can only manage to take this thing to the 38, well shy of the first down. Now here's Rigoberto Sanchez. Remember, though, he did have one blocked earlier. And did they keep it in? They did. They kept it in. It's down close to the goal line at the 1 yard line. The field position game often so overlooked, but this offense is going to be backed up deep. What an ideal punt.
And now, this stage of the game, when they need the drive to try and put themselves in a position to win it, you talk about going the long field, the very long field. This could be a 99-yard drive if they're able to accomplish it.
A busy night continues for Kamara. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
On any explosive run, you can almost feel the ground shaking, and that's from the offensive linemen creating space for their runners. I had an old coach tell me before that he always told his runners, run around the offensive line in pregame. Get used to the ground shaking so you don't trip and fall when it happens in a game.
They run it again with Kamara, and he'll get it up to the 12-yard line here. A gain of just a yard, but it's a first down.
Now that's the way to do it. Hand it to someone with vision and good footwork, and add in a little bit of power, and you find a way to pick up first downs.
Drew Brees, 6 fourth quarter comebacks a season ago, and that led the NFL. He'll try to deliver another one. On first and 10, here's Brees. Complete, Smith has it. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
That looked like a pretty good route combination there, because you've got to find a way to clear the guy running the drag, because when you do, you just put the ball on him and then let him run.
He's got some space. So first and 10 now from the 30. Working from the gun, it's Brees. And this is Cook with a grab. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Breeze on the draw, gives to Kamara. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
Ready. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Now Breeze. Again has it complete. He had a great move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. A gain of 6 there on first. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receiver's breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. Nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Breeze now perfect since the second half started. 7-7. It's first and 10. He gets it complete to Harris. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
It is hard in zone coverage to stop a curl route because when they see it, they just try and find the open spot and sit down.
Yeah, we always talk about finding the soft spot in the zone. What's the key to doing that? How do you do it?
You have to read what the coverage is. Is it too deep? Is it three deep? Because then you know where the linebackers are going to drop, what spots in the field they naturally get to, and you find that open space, and then you're in sync with your quarterback. He should be reading the exact same thing, and they put the ball right on you.
The Saints passing game in sync and moving the football. It's a first down. A looming decision to make on the conversion, down 7, but first things first, they need to score as they come up on first and goal. Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
Well, it's been the air game that's taken them down on this drive before they finally turned around and handed it off on the last play.
And now they're looking for the big boys to get them in the end zone. Couldn't do it there.
It'll be interesting to see. Offensive lines had to pass block a lot on this drive. Will they be able to revert and fire out and create some space in the run game?
Kamara trying again. He gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
Breeze now. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. It was Justin Houston, the native of Statesboro, Georgia, with a sack.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
The kick by Lutz is good. And that will cut this lead back down to 4 now. It's 17-13. So an interesting call there to take the 3. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the air.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. And now Indianapolis set to take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
The run on first down gets him a couple up to the 27. Big Sheldon Rankins there to bring him down. Offensively with the lead, you want to run the ball, keep the clock going, but you also want to still kind of be in attack mode too, right? So how do you do that and not come back on your heels?
Yeah, think about all the practices we've watched where they have that tempo period to go over things just like this, where they describe the scenario, tell you what they're looking for, and make sure that they're still attacking, yet at the same time not going so fast as to leave too much time on the clock.
They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that'll bring up a third down. Set from the gun on third. Throwing the out route and complete. That's Hines. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 7 and they pick up the first. Play fake. Here's Brissett. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Let's go.
A gain of 11 that time and a Colts first down.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down. Stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions. They are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. A little bit of space there for the first down run as that's going to get him about 5 yards. Tackle is made by Cameron Jordan.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. They keep it on the ground. Mac again. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
This a big play for both sides. What will we see here? Third and 4. From the gun, here's Brissett. He's got Jack Doyle. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 26.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker. Brissett going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. Brissett sets to throw it. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, 2nd and 10.
You get Rodney.
On the bootleg, it's Brissett. Into the hands of his running back, Marlon Mack. They'll get nothing out of that one, and it's going to lead to a third down.
Usually the offense has an answer to anything a defense throws at them, including a safety valve, and that's what they did on that play. They went there, but the defense still made an excellent play and held them to no gain.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. Complete to Hilton. And that's not nearly going to be enough. Stopped at the 22, and he needed plenty more. That hold coming from the left side of the line.
Hands got caught in the cookie jar on that one, and the flag came out. Penalty against them.
Let's go.
Third and 10 wasn't going to be easy. Now after the holding penalty, they have to deal with a third and 20. Brissett again. And that is incomplete. Looked like he had a couple of different options as far as who to throw to on that play. And who am I to say this, but I'm not sure he made the right decision.
Well, the window of opportunity is always going to be small in the NFL. That's why those quarterbacks who make quick decisions and have quick releases have the most success in this league.
And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. So Breeze and the Saints down 17-13, 2:15 remaining. Plenty of time here. They've got three timeouts and the two-minute warning as they've got it first and 10. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. From the gun, it's Breeze. The catch made over the middle by Ginn. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Well, when you're leading in the fourth quarter, that's not the penalty you want.
Not at all. And now your discipline comes into question. Having poise this stage of the game, you can't have those kind of plays.
And now it's first and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. Shotgun now for Breeze. That one complete to Hill. And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four.
Ready. 95-56. 95-56.
Let's go.
Throwing again on second down. Breeze. It's brought in right side by Ginn. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. They got exactly what they wanted there. Out route, catch, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
And I have to criticize defense here because you know the situation. You want to keep them inbounds and have the clock run. So I'm sitting on the outside portion of the field and not letting them throw an out route. Throw anything inside and I'll make the tackle. An out route? That's not the way you're supposed to play it.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. It's a gain of a yard and it'll set up second and goal.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Clock running, about to hit 90 seconds to go in the game. Now Breeze. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints have taken the lead.
Wow, I know it's a never-say-never situation, but to me, that looks like that's the one that's going to finish them off.
A score that puts them in front here late, but now you got to rally your kick team, don't you, and say the last thing we need is a big return.
And what happens is guys get overeager, get out of their lane because they're so excited they want to make the last tackle. You mess up, could come back at you a long way.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Here comes the Colts offense now as they make their way onto the field. They're only in need of a field goal, a decent amount of time on the clock, so tell me if I'm wrong. You don't have to be too panicked here.
No, not at all. I agree with you. And this is where your preparation and your confidence comes into play. They've worked on these situations.
Yeah, they practice this all the time.
They practice it all the time. They know what they want to get done. And in a lot of cases, the great competitors, they love this situation. They think they can go ahead and get it done.
They practiced it. We'll see if practice makes perfect. A good pickup there, 21 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling. Brissett looks to throw. Take it in by the tight end, Doyle. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
Sometimes it's hard to figure, but you can live with incompletions in this situation. You can't live with these short gains that take time off the clock.
You know who loves it? This defense. Now the Colts moving quickly here in the hurry-up offense. Brissett. That's into the hands of Pascal. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. The Colts going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 27 seconds showing on the clock. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Back to throw. Looking left sideline, it's complete. 16 yards to pick up there. The Colts have a first down. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
Brissett going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now the Colts going to burn the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Pass protection has been a problem all night long as they come up facing second and a bundle. Here's Marlon Mack. Now the Colts will use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 13 seconds left to play. Adam Vinatieri, the oldest player in the NFL, on for the Colts field goal. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Vinatieri now on to try the field goal for the Colts. This to potentially send us to overtime. And his kick is indeed good. And they will tie this game here in the final seconds. So a money kick there in the final seconds. And now, barring any hijinks on the kickoff here, partner, I think you and I, we're going to settle in for a little overtime.
And I wouldn't have it any other way. This has been a dogfight all through regulation. No reason to think it won't continue in the extra period.
Fitting for what's been a tight ball game. We're all even at 20 now as the kick's away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They have a little bit of time here to get into field goal range. Not much. A tie game, you don't want to do anything crazy, right?
I agree with you on that one. Risk reward, okay? If you go for it, what is the absolute reward on this? But the risk is probably greater. Run the clock out, get to overtime, and try and win it there.
All right, we'll see if they do just that. A pretty big opening there on first down. 8 yards up to the 33. And now with 4 seconds left, we get a timeout call. And now the Saints get set to trot out there. 8 yards the gain on that last run. Here's second and a couple. Breeze to throw. And going deep for Hill. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Final whistle blows, and we need some extra time here to decide who will be the victor.
60 minutes, just not enough some days to decide who's going to win the game.
And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their 25-yard line. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara, and he's taken down but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there. Good for a Saints first down.
That was good, tough running right up the middle. And if the defense can't penetrate and make him slow his pace or change direction, that's often the end result.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Running with Kamara. And he will force his way forward for a yard or two, but I have a good feeling this will be coming back. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. First throw of overtime for Breeze. That's to his running back. It's Alvin Kamara. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one good for 20 on the catch and run.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. But anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
On first down, Murray. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Again, it's Murray. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a third down and 6.
Well, how about the big guy there showing some agility? He just flowed from his D-tackle position in order to make that play.
Opening drive of overtime, and now facing a third down and 6. Big play coming up. Bree's going to throw. And going deep for Hill. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Now give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Well, I know you're toward the middle of the field here, but still, fourth down this distance, you got to punt it, right?
That's definitely the first instinct, because you say, okay, let's just play some field position, make sure we don't lose the game here, turn it over in a key spot. But if you feel really good about your trigger guy, if you feel great about him, you might want to leave the ball in his hands and let him work his magic.
And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. Now a first throw here in overtime. And do you believe this? It's a safety, and the ball game is over. A partner, a great game that we got to see and making it extra special. Not only did I get 4 quarters with you in this one, I got some overtime, a little whipped cream on top.
Look at you, trying to make this whole thing palatable.
I just want you to pay for my meal later.
You really just wanted 4 quarters, what you wanted. But how much fun was that? We had that type of a game where we got us to overtime, and then we get the dramatic ending to finish things off as well. What a game.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA.